Hi, welcome to our online session of the Christian Meditation Prayer Group of St. Mary's Church in Killarney. And you're very welcome to join us for this session. And if you're following us at a later time, catching up with us, also you're very welcome to join us here today. The broadcast is being made available at 7 p.m. on our usual Friday slot, so as to tie in with your diaries for regular weekly gatherings. So, as I said, you're very welcome. We're going to commence our meditation shortly, but first of all we're going to prepare ourselves and place ourselves within the context of God's presence. So, let us close our eyes and let us relax our body. And let us place ourselves consciously and deliberately in the presence of God, reflecting on God's continued and permanent presence closer to ourselves than we are to ourselves, as St. Augustine says. That God underpins reality, and we bring ourselves deliberately and lovingly into consciousness of that presence, and offer our meditation to God as a prayer for our own renewal and for renewal of the world. And at the sound of the gong, we will bring into our mind our sacred word, Maranatha. Everybody okay? Good. That's good. This Sunday is Trinity Sunday, and traditionally we speak of the nature of God in three aspects, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. And one of the things that has struck me recently is the way in which the meditation tradition and the mystics of the Christian Church in previous centuries have in a way integrated the ideas that come to us from the early fathers of the Church, the scholars who worked at trying to comprehend and understand the nature of this this particular piece of theology. And Jesus talking about the Father and talking about the Son and talking about the Holy Spirit. And of course in the Gospel of John, the great discourse at the Last Supper, where Jesus is talking to God about his mission and the ways in which he has introduced the apostles to the deeper things of God. And he asks that God will make them all one, as indeed he and God the Father are one also. And this idea, this concept of oneness, we often focus on Trinity Sunday, on the threeness of God. But what is the oneness of God? And what does our meditation practice do for us to help us connect both intellectually and spiritually with that oneness of God? The Christian tradition, and indeed other traditions, all point to the same thing. When the person who is meditating reaches the finest levels of their ability to be present, the finest levels in which they are able to overcome the interruptions from the wayward mind, from the ego, from the external pressures of life, when they reach that moment where they can actually sit there in complete inner stillness and with a sense of great calm and quiet, what is it they find? What do they tell us about the nature of that experience? Well, they all tell us the same thing, and that is that when we arrive at that place, what we experience is the infinite presence of God and the experience of that infinity of presence. It's like a vast landscape where you can't see the horizon, and the only thing that you become aware of in that vastness is the presence of divine love. That is the divine love with which God created the universe. That is the divine love with which God upholds the universe. That divine love is the reason we are present, the very fact of our presence is underpinned. Our own reality is underpinned by the divine love. And it is that divine love which is so gentle and so quiet and so peaceful, so energizing, so persuasive and so informative of God's nature, that we ourselves become part of it. We ourselves become, as it were, one with it. There are all kinds of analogies that come to mind. Teresa of Avila talks about the way that raindrops mingling with rivers, you cannot tell which is the raindrop and which is the river at the point of mingling, and with the river and sea as well. All kinds of images and ideas that come forth. The idea of a great landscape, the idea of an infinity of presence. All of these are very inadequate and poor descriptions of the nature of the oneness of God and the way in which we become one with God, what in the Orthodox tradition is called theosis, making the human divine. We are not God ourselves, but we become present to God in God's oneness. And the experience is so powerful for us, so penetrating for us, that it gives us those same qualities that the oneness, the love of God carries. And we carry those in our lives and in the world around us, and by virtue of the experience of being connected with that love, with that oneness. So our meditation practice then is like the refiner's fire that we mentioned at a previous time, where that love is casting out and pushing away all of the hindrances, the obstacles, the constructions, the manifestations of our own inadequacies. These are the things that are being burned off, are being evicted, if you will, by that powerful love of God. And as the layers of our vulnerabilities are removed, so we become more and more aware of the power of the love of God, of its presence, so that finally even the capacity to be aware itself goes, and all we are conscious of is the fact of awareness, not of any objects, not of any structures, not of any constructs, not of any ideas, but the mere fact of awareness itself. And that is really hard to put into words, because of course words are objects, and we have given up any form of objectification when we are in that state of presence with God. So the fact of awareness itself is the underpinning of our capacity to engage with the God who is present with us now. And so Trinity Sunday gives us an opportunity to think of these things, to be conscious of them, and to use this learning, this tradition of the Church, as a way of placing ourselves, placing our consciousness and our desire in the right frame of mind, so that we can move along that path and eventually engage with God as God is and as we will become. So, God bless you this Trinity Sunday. God lead you on this path. God bring you to the place of insight and experience, so that you too may have the experience of the presence of God as the profoundest and most powerful experience of love, which is pure and holy and life-giving. So I pray that for you, and ask God's Spirit to empower you during your meditations in the coming days. So God bless you and keep you safe and well. Look forward to seeing you the next time for our in-person session or online of the Christian Meditation Prayer Group in St. Mary's Church in Killarney. And may you be at peace in the coming days. Amen. Goodbye.